Good morning, students. This is Sridevi. In our previous session, we will discuss about some of the topics in Unit 3. In this session, I will teach remaining topics in third unit. And the topics are event ordering, mutual exclusion, deadlock, and election algorithm. First, let us see what is an event ordering.
What is an event ordering? A system of clocks that ensures you can always tell the order of two events in the system. When two events cannot influence each other through messages, they are considered concurrent despite their ordering in physical time. We can now use these timestamps to order all events in the system using an arbitrary ordering when timestamps are ambiguous. It's important to note that while the partial ordering from before is unique, the total ordering of events depends on clock choice and the arbitrariness of ordering events when no causal link exists. In partial ordering of events in a distributed system, one way to define an order of events in distributed system would be to have a physical clock. So, happened before event can be described using T1 less than T2. T1 less than T2 is described as happened before. But clocks are not accurate, can drift and are not necessarily synchronized in lockstep. So this paper takes another approach to define happened before relationship. This meaning of partial order will become clear later. In distributed system can be defined as a collection of processes. A process essentially consists of a queue of events. In this event, let's establish a more precise definition of happened before its arrow mark in such a system. In the process, if event A comes before event B, then A to B. When process I sends from message at A to process J and process J acknowledges this message at B, then also A to B. It happens before is transitive. A to B and B to C, then A to C. This is the swapping order. Two events A and B are described as concurrent when A has not happened before B and B has not happened before A. This condition generally reflects the fact that process I may not have knowledge about all events that could have happened in process J. So we cannot establish authoritative order in the system. This also makes it clear when we have only partial order in the system. There could be a lot of events in the system for which no meaningful order can be established without relying on physical time. This is the process of event before A to B. Taking some examples might be useful. Let us see following diagram. As you can see in the figure on the left above, P1 to P2. As though are the events in the same process, Q1 and Q2. Due to sending of the message from process Q to the process P. Partial ordering of events in the system, vertical bars are processes, way arrows are messages, a dot is an event, time elapses bottom up. In this time of process, if we consider that time is elapsing bottom up and Q3 seems to happen before P3. If we are consider physical time, but in this time we will call these events as concurrent. Both processes don't know about these events. There is no causal relationship at this time. But what we can say is that Q3 to Q4 because Q3 to Q5 and Q5 to Q4. Similarly, we can say that P1 to R3. Now, having gone through some examples, it becomes clear that any other way to evenate A to B is that event can causally affect to event B. On a similar note, Q3 and P3 mentioned above are not causally related. This is the process of event ordering. Next concept is mutual exclusion. A mutual exclusion is a process that prevents multiple threats or process from accessing shared resource at the time. This is the main definition of a mutual exclusion. In distributed system, we neither have shared memory nor a common physical clock, and therefore we cannot solve mutual exclusion problem using shared variables. To eliminate the mutual exclusion problem in distributed system, approach based on the message passing is used. A site and distributed system do not have complete information of state of the system due to lack of shared memory and a common physical clock. A main mutual exclusion is a concurrency control property which is introduced to prevent race conditions. It is requirement that a process cannot enter its critical section while another concurrent process is currently present or executing in its critical section. That is, only one process is allowed to execute the critical section at any given instance of time. It makes sure that concurrent process access shared resource or data in a serialized way. Okay, no process can access a shared resource when any other process is accessing the same resources. Some example, sending interrupt signals to IO devices. This is the mutual exclusion. In that manner, only one process is allowed to execute the critical session at any given time. Already we discussed, in a distributed system, shared variables or a local kernel cannot be used to implement mutual exclusions. In this, message passing is the sole means of implementing distributed mutual exclusion. And mutual exclusion ensures that no other processes will be shared resource at any time. Three algorithms are presented, that is centralized algorithm, distributed algorithm, and token algorithm. One process is elected as coordinator whenever process wants to enter a critical region. It sends request message to coordinator asking for permissions. If no other process is currently in that critical region, the coordinator sends back a reply granting permissions. When reply arrives, the request process enters the critical region. If the coordinator knows that a different process is already in critical region, so it is cannot be granted permissions. First algorithm is the centralized algorithm. In centralized algorithm, figure 1 shows there are 4 sections, that means 0, 1, 2, 3. And from the section 1 to section 3, request has been sent, and from section 3, it grants the permission and sends the reply to section 1. So, in that time queue is empty. In figure shows, from the section 2 and section 3 has been received the request, but the request is not acceptable, so there is no reply. From section 3 and section 2 is not received any reply, so the queue is 2. In figure 3 shows, from section 1 has been received a request and it is acceptable and sends reply to section 2, and then also queue is an empty. This is the centralized algorithm. In centralized algorithm, advantages are, it grants mutual exclusion, it's a fair approach, request granted in first come first serve manner. There is no starvation. Starvation means name given to the indefinite postponement of a process because it requires some resource before it can run. But the resource though available for allocation is never allocated to the process. That is the starvation. In centralized algorithm, there is no starvation is the advantage. And it is easy to implement, and it can only 3 messages per use of critical sessions, that is request, grant, and release. Drawbacks of centralized algorithm. Single point of failure. It's dead coordinate and permission denied cannot distinguish. In large systems, single coordinators can create performance bottleneck. This is the main drawbacks of centralized algorithm. Next algorithm is distributed algorithm. In this algorithm, timestamps are used for distributed mutual exclusion. And it contains of algorithm, that is Kairot and Agrawal's algorithm. When process wants to enter critical region, it builds message containing name of critical region is process, number and current time. It sends message to all including itself, and if receiver if not in critical region and does not want to enter it, sends back OK message to sender. If the receiver is already in critical region, it does not reply. Instead, it queues request. If the receiver wants to enter critical region but has not yet done, so it compares the timestamp in the incoming message, the lowest one wins. In this algorithm, it is own message has lower timestamp. The receiver queues the incoming request and sends nothing. And drawbacks of this distributed algorithm is, if any process fails, that means crashes, that it does not respond to request. It can be misinterpreted as denial of permission. Thus, many cause blocking of all processes. About RPCart and Agarwal solutions is, some algorithm with reply always given a receiver either by granting or denying permissions. And other problem is bottleneck. Solution can be given with permission from simple majority of processes rather than from all with conditions that a process granted permission to one, that a process granted permission to one process cannot grant other permission until first has been released. And next algorithm is the token ring algorithm. In token ring algorithm consists mutual exclusion token ring algorithm. It is a congruency control property which is introduced to prevent race conditions. It is requirement that a process cannot enter its critical sessions while another concurrent process is currently present or executing in its critical section, that is only one process is allowed to execute the critical session at any given time of instance. In software, a logical ring is constructed in which each process is assigned a position in the ring. The ring positions may be allocated in numerical order of network address or some other means. It does not matter what the ordering is. All that matter is that each process knows who is next in line after itself. This is a mutual exclusion token ring algorithm. Working of token ring algorithm. Let us see unordered group of processing network, a logical ring constructed in software figures. When the ring is initialized, process 0 is given a token. The token circulates around the ring. It passes from process K to process KT. That means module the ring size in point to point messages. Okay. When a process acquires the token from its neighbor, it checks to see if it is attempting to enter a critical region. If so, the process enters the region, does all the work it needs to and leaves the region. After it existed, it passes the token along the ring. It is not permitted to enter the second critical region with using the same token. If a process is handed the token by its neighbor and is not interested in entering a critical region, it just passes it along. As the sequence, when no process wants to enter any critical regions, the token just circulates at high speed around the ring. Only one process has the token at any instant. So only one process can actually may be in the critical region. This is the unordered group of processes in a network and a logical ring constructed in software. This is the working of token ring algorithm. And next concept is the deadlock. What is a deadlock? A deadlock is a situation in which two computer programs sharing the same resources are efficiently preventing each other from accessing the resources, resulting the both programs easing to function. The earliest computer operating systems ran only one program at a time. All of the resources of the system were available to this in one program. Later, operating system ran multiple programs at once, interleaving them. This is the deadlocks. Programs were required to specify in advance what resources they needed so that they could avoid conflicts with other programs running at the same time. Eventually, some operating systems offered dynamic allocation of resources. Programs could request further allocations of resources after they had begun and running. A set of processes is deadlocked if each process in this set is waiting for an event that only other process in this set can cause. Suppose process D holds resource T and process C holds resource U. Now process D requests resource U and process C requests resource T. But none of process will get these resource because these resources are already held by other process. So both can be blocked, with neither one be able to process. This situation is called a deadlock. Programs could request further allocations of resources after they had been begin and running. For example, figure A holding a resources, requesting a resources and deadlock. As shown in figure, resource T assigned to process D and resource U is assigned to process C. Process D is requesting or waiting for resource U, and process C is requesting or waiting for resource C. Process C and D are in deadlock over resources T and U. This is the resource allocation graphs in deadlocks. Next is conditions that lead to deadlock. There are four conditions that must be holding deadlock. Mutual exclusion condition. Each resource is either currently assigned to exactly one process or is available. And second condition is hold and wait condition. It process currently holding resource granted and earlier can request more resources. No prevention condition. It previously granted resources can be forcibly taken away from the process. And next condition is circular wait condition. There must be circular chain of two or more processes. Each process is waiting for resource that is held by next member of the chain. All four of these conditions must be present for a deadlock to occur. In this deadlock, release after the process has finished using the allocated resource, it releases the resource of the system. The system table records are updated at the time of allocation and release to reflect the current status of availability of resources. A deadlock is a situation in which two computer programs sharing the some resources are effectively preventing each other from accessing the resources, result in both program easing to functions. This is the deadlocks in distributed system. Okay, next concept is the election algorithm. In election algorithm, choose a process from group of process to act as a coordinator. It perform coordination activity needs for the smooth running of process. Two examples of such coordinator process encountered here are the coordinator in the centralized algorithm for mutual exclusion. Already we will discussed in previous question. Okay, the centralized coordinator in the centralized deadlock detection algorithm. If the coordinator process fails, a new coordinator process must be elected to take up the job of the failed coordinator. In these election algorithms are meant for electing a coordinator process from the currently running process. These algorithms are based on the some exceptions, and these exceptions are each process in the system has a unique priority number. Whenever an electrician is held, the process having the highest priority number among the currently activity process is elected as the coordinator. On recovery, a failed process can take appropriate actions to rejoin the set of active processes. In these election algorithms, consists of two types. They are Boolean election and ring election. First one is the Boolean election. Boolean algorithm for election. In this algorithm specifies the process with the highest identifier will be the coordinator of the group. It works as the follows. When a process P detects that the coordinator is not responding to request, it initiates an election. P sends an election message to all process with higher numbers. If nobody responds, then P wins and takes over. If one of the process answers, then P jobs is done. This is the initiates an election. If a process receives an election message from a lower numbered process at any time, it sends an OK message back and it holds an election. A process announces its victory by sending all process a messages telling them that is the new coordinator. If a process has been down recovers, it holds an election. Look, let us see these diagrams, figure A and figure B, figure C and figure D and figure E. Figure A represents process 4 holds an election, and figure B represents process 5 and 6 respond, and figure C represents no 5 and 6 each hold an election, and figure D represents process 6 tells 5 to stop, and figure E represents process 6 wins and tells everyone. The group consists of 8 process numbered from 0 to 7. Previously process 7 was the coordinator, but it has just crashed. Process 4 is the first one to notice this, so it sends election message to all the process higher than it, namely 5, 6 and 7 as shown in the figure A. In figure B, process 5 and 6 both respond with OK. Upon getting the first to all these responses, 4 knows that its job is over. It knows that one of these big weeks will take over the become coordinator. It just sits back and waits to see who the winner will be. In figure C, both 5 and 6 hold elections, each one only sending messages, and those process higher than itself. In figure D, process 6 tells 5, that is, will take over. At this point, 6 knows that 7 is dead and that is 6 is the winner. If there is state information to be collected from disk or else where to pick up where the old coordinator left off, 6 must now do what is needed. When it is ready to take over, 6 announces this by sending a coordinator messages to all running processes. When 4 gets these messages, it can now continue with the operation it also trying to do. When it discovered that 7 was dead, but using 6 as the coordinator in this time. In this way, the failure of 7 is handled and the work can continue. If process 7 is ever restarted, it will just send all the others a coordinator message and bully the minimum to submission. This is the Boolean election algorithm. Next algorithm is the ring algorithm. In this algorithm, assumes that the process are arranged in logical ring and each process is knowing the order of the ring of process. In this, election algorithm applies to system organized as a ring, that is logically or physically. In this algorithm, we can assume that the link between process and unconditional, and every process can message on its write only. In data structure, that this algorithm used in active list. A list has a priority number of all active process in the system. If any process defect failures, it constructs an election message with its process ID. That is, it's for example, its network addresses and local process ID and sends to neighbor. If the neighbor is down, the process skips over it and sends the message to the next process to the ring. Next process in the ring. This process is repeated until a running process is located. At each step, the process adds its own process ID to the list in the message and sends the message to its living neighbor. The process then picks either the highest or lowest process ID in the list and sends out a message to the grouping information, them to the new coordinator. Let us see the diagram. Figure 1 shows a ring of 6 processes. P2 detects that the coordinator P0 is dead. It starts an election by sending an election message containing its process ID to its neighbor P3. This is also figure 1. In figure 2, P3 receives an election message and sends an election message to its neighbor with the ID of P3 suffixed to the list. The same sequence of events occurs with P4, which adds to ID to the list. It received from P3 and sends an election message to P5. In figure 3, P5 then tries to send an election message to P0. In figure 4, P0 is dead and the message is not delivered. P5 tries again to its neighbor P1. In figure 5, the message is received by P2, the origin of the election. In P2 recognizes that is the initiator of the election before its ID is the first in the list of processes. It then picks a leader. It chooses the lowest numbered process ID, which is that of P1. In figure 6, it then informs the rest of the group of the new coordinator. This is the ring algorithm. Thank you.